Hi guys, today's video is on my Sisterlocks history slash journey or why I chose Sisterlocks. Alright, basically Sisterlocks chose me. Did it really choose me? Was I chose it, but it was calling me, so to speak. Okay, why do I say that? First, I want to start off, I used to be a weave queen. When I tell you I was a weave queen, weave, individual braids, it didn't matter. It did not matter. It was like an addiction. And one day I decided I can't take the addiction anymore because every time I let down my hair, like if I would do individual braids and I unravel, you know, you take out your braids and so forth like that, I couldn't seem to leave the house. So it was like, okay, my hair is natural. I don't want to go outside with it looking this way. So I would tie it up and it's a hot mess. I had to do something about that. And I said to myself, this is not good. That's just basically it. This is not good. So I shaved off all my hair. And when I say I wore low, when I tell you low, it was low. It wasn't a teeny weeny fro. It wasn't something that you can pick. It wasn't even enough hair you could twist. The only way you can comb it was to brush it. Is it a buzz cut or is it a Caesar? I really can't remember the hairstyle. All I know is I ain't have no hair. Okay, so I wore that for a couple of years. And I basically said I was going to keep it short until I lost the desire to put anything in it. And as time went on, it wasn't easy to wear a buzz cut all the time because you want versatile, you want versatility, you want to be sexy. I find I had to dress more feminine because it's like, who's that little fella over there? That was not a good feeling. So when I lost the urge to put anything in it, I was like, okay, I'm ready to grow my hair out. So I grew my hair out and I started with the, I think it's the coil twist or so forth like that. Like you do with the rat tail combs, the gel twist. I did the gel twist for a little while. After the gel twist, I said, okay, well, let me see if I will, you know, grow it into traditional locks. I did that for 6 months and that didn't do too well with me because I kept fiddling with it. As it started to grow out, it was like, oh, I got to twist it. It has to be neat. Everything has to be perfect. And my hair didn't like it. My hair started to break off because it did not like being twisted so much. And as they tell you with locks, when you start it off, you have to, you know, give it a rest or so forth in between twisting. Okay, now, as I was considering Sisterlocks, this is during the time when I had the buzz cut. And when I decided to do the traditional, and in the process, I was reading. I was reading a ton of natural hair care books. I read Dr. Joanne's Let's Talk Hair. I think that's the name of it. That's the purple book. So long ago I read that. And then she had another book that came out, and I was going online, and I was looking at pictures. And at that time, there wasn't plenty pictures out. But it took me 4 years to decide. So with my belt, with the traditional, I got my hair done. At that time, to get the Sisterlocks was $325. I know it's a lot more now, but it's worth it. It is so, 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 so worth it. All right, so I did the Sisterlocks. When I first got it done, I was ecstatic and happy about it. And then after my whole head was done, I don't know about now, but back then I kind of like had a heart attack because people used to look at me and like, what you doing over there with that? Why your head look like that? Why you have 50 million micros with no extensions in it? So I just dealt with it. Now when you get Sisterlocks, you see so many natural women about, you have so many styles, you have all these YouTube videos and all this type of stuff to help encourage and inspire people to keep going. As the years accumulated, people who didn't like it in the beginning started to like it as my hair got longer. And that's basically it as far as others' approval. Was I studying other people's approval? No. Why did I even have natural hair to begin with? Because I wanted to own my own beauty. What do I mean by that? If you gave me a compliment and you said, Fen, that's what the P stands for. Fen, you're beautiful. I could own it. I could own it. If I looked myself in the mirror and I saw that I looked nice, I could own it. I didn't feel like, oh yeah, okay, well, you think I look nice or so forth, but imagine what I look like underneath this. I wanted to own it fully. What else is there? What are my thoughts on being natural, straight hair, tracks, relaxers? I don't have any, oh, you should be natural. Oh, you should be relaxed. I don't have any of those wars or anything like that. I look at a lot of hairstyles that are done on naturally straight hair or on tracked or hair with extensions. They inspire me. A lot of the hairstyles that I mimic or I do a variation of is on straight hair. This is my version of straight hair. I don't care if you have traditional locks. I don't care if you have sister locks, twisty locks, whatever kind of locks. It's a super strand. You determine how fine or how thick you want that super strand to be. So therefore, my hair can be nappy, kinky, coily, whatever terminology you want to give it. It can be all those things and still thrive in its natural pattern and the way it wants to grow, but it's going to be in a super strand. That's basically it. I think the locks is the system. Just like when somebody has a relaxer, they don't say, oh, my relaxer is a hairstyle. No, it's the system that one employs to deliver their hairstyle. Okay, well, suppose I'm natural. Okay, you're natural and you have an afro. That's how you prefer to deliver your hairstyle in a afro. But yet you still style your hair. People who have naturally straight hair don't say, oh, okay, am I repeating myself? I'm trying to remember. Okay, people whose hair is naturally straight, they don't say, oh, well, this is my hairstyle for today. They no, they still style their hair. So it's the same thing, I think, also with natural hair or locks. You style it. I don't think locks per se is the hairstyle. Okay, trying to remember. Someone has asked me if I ever cut my hair. I've cut my hair 5 inches. I started with four to 5 inches roughly when I started. I cut my hair when it hit waist length. It was 5 inches. Basically, it was the hair, the original hair, when you first get the Sisterlocks because the ends used to like spaz out or they compressed or compacted, they swelled out and they were kind of tough. That part was cut off. Okay, I think I covered everything. I just want to tell you all thank you to my subscribers. When I threw these videos up, it was more of a thing of pushing my comfort zone because I was given. It's not like a dare, but more of an assignment of getting comfortable and doing more things and getting out from under my rock and my shell. So I started throwing up these videos. I had no clue what I'd be talking about, and then it dawned on me, hey, just talk about hair or something of that nature. But I want to thank my subscribers, and if anyone has any suggestions, whether it be yeah, suggestions, comments, your opinion, please feel free to share. Help me out. I need suggestions. Or if you would like to see a certain type of hairstyle, or if you ask me to recreate a hairstyle, that'll give me an assignment to work on it for natural hair or locks. Please feel free to leave a comment. You can inbox me. You can email me and I will get back to you in whatever form of fashion you prefer. All right, guys, I'm signing off. PR Charles. Peace.